city stuck in the clouds. She begs me to come down, says, boy, quit fooling around. I told her I love the view from up here. Warm sun and wind in my ear will watch the world from above as it turns to the rhythm of love. We may only.
So, my favorite physical feature about Emily, when we first started dating, something about her hair was my favorite. Like, I remember always for our first couple dates, I would ask, are you curling your hair? And she quickly caught on to that, and even a year or two in, she would always ask me, like, how do you want me to do my hair? Because she knew that I liked that so much about her. Her gorgeous dark brown hair, it was really long when we met. She's cut it a couple times, she's put blonde in it, just everything about it. I don't know what it was, but from day one, I've always thought she was beautiful in that way.
Oh, he always makes fun of me for this, but I like his hands. They're like masculine, and like he always goes like this, and I don't know, I like his hands. Freshman year in college, we were both in the same freshman leadership organization, and then we actually weren't friends at all, really, the first year that we met. I think the first time we had actually ever talked was I was complaining about the t-shirt design for like our organization, and I think that was like literally the first words I'd ever said to him. And then we got paired up. We like both applied to be on staff for that organization, then we got partnered. So that over the next year we were kind of like trying not to have a relationship because it was looked down upon in the organization, and then pretty much right whenever it ended we started dating.
Got on staff for this organization, so now there's about 10 of us, 12 of us, and we go on something called a staff retreat in the summer where we kind of talk about the organization for the next year and plan and do all this stuff. And at that retreat, her and I ended up talking after all of the events were over that day, and we ended up staying up all night. I don't even think we went to bed. We just stayed out on the back patio by ourselves, literally watched the sunrise, just us, and then had to drive like 3 hours back the next day. And but I remember being so pumped about just being able to talk to her and staying up all night. I was just on cloud nine driving back. I was super tired, but it didn't matter. And I remember like checking my phone periodically on that drive home to see if she texted me. And when I got home, I had a text from her like, did you make it home or something like that? And I was pumped.
So our first kiss was actually like super awkward, which I'm sure no one is surprised about. But Braxton, I was driving him home. We lived in like the same apartment complex. And we had like just started dating, and he was like so timid and awkward around me, and I'm also awkward, so it was like a bad combination. But I think I was driving him home, and he was getting out of the passenger seat, and he actually got out of the car, and then I could tell he was like sitting there thinking about something, and then he like came back in the car and was like, is it okay if I kiss you? And I was like, yeah. And then so he gave me like a little peck and then just like shut the door and ran off. And it was super awkward, but that was our first kiss.
And I just asked, I was like, is it okay if I kiss you? And she kind of was like, sure, or something like that. Not very like inviting. I was still nervous even after I got the yes, because I was just like, oh, I don't want to screw this up. Like, I don't actually know if that's something she wants me to do, but she said yes, and I was like, okay. And anyways, but I kissed her and everything was fine, but it was a very funny introduction. If any of you guys, which I know you do, know Emily, that's like one of the funniest things was our first kiss. Me asking her and her kind of like, response, so.
My favorite personality trait about Braxton, I don't know, there's a lot. He has such a good personality. I love how hard he works, like in his job and then CrossFit, and just, I mean, everything that he does like to the max, which can be really annoying, but also is really, really cool. He definitely grounds me back down on planet Earth, which is nice. I just love how hardworking and like family oriented that he is.
My favorite personality trait about him. There's a lot, obviously, that's why I chose to marry her, but on a more serious one, her drive, her ambition to do exactly what she's setting out in this world to do. I mean, from the beginning of knowing her, it's always been career first, like I have to do this. Can't you just take a break for a second? No, like, you know, I have to get this done. I have to be the best of the best in order to make it to where I'm at. And she's still like in the middle of that journey, and she never settles. She never cuts corners. Like, she does it the hard way. And that's exactly what's gotten her to the place she's at in her life. And I think I was kind of oriented that way too, but after having dated her, she is definitely like brings me up a level too.
Okay, so actually this is really cute. I knew that Braxton was the one the day that he asked me to be exclusive. So he came over and we like kind of talked about it because we had been, I don't know, more than friends, but pretending we were friends for like a year because of that organization that we were in, we couldn't technically date. And so the second that ended, pretty much, he came over and was like, I like you, I want to see where this is going. So we decided that we were going to be exclusive, but we were also best friends at the same time, so we didn't want to put any pressure on it. So like, we're just going to take things really slow and just be exclusive and then maybe go on a date or two and see how it feels. And then I lived with Katie, and I went in her bedroom that night and I said, I don't think I'm ever going to be single again. I actually have a really funny picture of her reacting to that.
When did I know Emily was the one? Sophomore year, very early into our relationship. It's probably 3 or 4 months into our relationship at this time. And something that was a horrible event, Hurricane Harvey, hits Houston, and therefore, you know, College Station is right there, and that kind of comes through and runs through campus and everything, and it's flooding, and we can't go to class, like they cancel class for a week essentially, and it's just raining nonstop. And we had just started dating, and I remember I had said, "Oh, why don't you come over to my house, like." You know, we have no class or whatever. And so, you know, through this rainstorm, essentially, we just hung out all day, every day that week. I remember just like calling the pizza place and them not even believing that we would be crazy enough to go out there and try to get something in the middle of the rainstorm, and us just walking over there in the middle of the rain, walking outside, like doing things in the middle of this hurricane, essentially, just spending time together and laughing and just learning more about each other, just uninterrupted long periods of time. That's one of our favorite TV shows that we still rewatch pretty much every day to this day. Started during that hurricane, that storm. I remember being, wanting to spend as much time as possible with her and just thinking like, I can't believe how lucky I was and how excited I was to continue our relationship. And that's when I was like, man, without realizing it, I started thinking about marriage at that point in time. I was like, this is something that like, she's gotta be the one. Like, this is awesome. She's amazing. She's getting me outside in the rain, which my family knows that something I would never do on my own. Doing that kind of thing, getting me out of my comfort zone, hanging out, laughing, spending time together, time just stops in situations like that. And we don't think about anything else in the world. And after, you know, that whole situation, I was like, man, I love this girl. She's amazing. That's for sure the woman I want to spend the rest of my life with. Here we are. You
Our favorite thing to do together has definitely changed over the years. Like when we were back in college, we loved to go to Aggie football games together. That was like our thing. We loved to go to every single game. We stayed, well, as long as we could. He would want to stay the whole time. I couldn't stay the whole time. But we loved to go to Aggie football games, Aggie baseball games. I think that was like our second date was to a baseball game. And then after college, we kind of got into running. So now we like to go on these like long 10-mile like run walks together. We have like a favorite trail in Austin that we drive to. It's called Lady Bird Lake Trail. We like to be active. We like to go outside and spend time together.
So our favorite thing to do together, the first thing that comes to my mind is something in our relationship we've always enjoyed doing is just is being active, being outside. Sitting on the balcony of either of our apartments, really, for as long as I can remember. And when COVID happened and the whole world shut down, I remember visiting her and just not being able to do anything, really, because we were locked down. And that's when we started walking this trail outside of her apartment in San Antonio every day. That was how we escaped, how we got out, and then that turned into running and doing more, and those walks and runs, I mean, yes, it was exercise, and a lot of great came from it. Like, we've run a lot of races together, just kind of traveling Texas and doing that, but that became our times I look back on that I really, really cherish in our relationship. That was when she was going through the thick of it in dental school and just studying all day, every day. The only way we could spend time together was going on those walks and me just flashcarding her just over and over for hours. Just walking, flashcarding, taking a break, talking, keep walking, flashcard, run, stop, flashcard. I mean, the whole time. We would talk about life, where we see things going. Because at the time I was still at A&M in College Station doing my fifth year of school, and just everything that comes with that. It's being active together, spending time outside together, talking about our lives, doing her school, just the flashcarding and how funny it is to think about those times and where we are now, but times I wouldn't trade for sure. Just all of that I look back on, and another horrible situation that is COVID that was happening at that time was with her, some of my favorite memories, at least.
So Braxton proposed on our 5-year anniversary in Rome, Italy. So I kind of had a sneaking suspicion that he was gonna propose because everyone was acting super weird before we went on the trip, saying I needed special outfits and tell me to get my nails done. So I kind of had a feeling it was gonna happen. I just didn't know when. The day that it happened, it was on our 5-year anniversary, and I woke up like in a really good mood and was like singing and dancing, and Braxton was like in the corner, like all focused and like serious, and he kept telling me that he's trying to get in the zone. I still didn't catch on. I don't know why. I was just like having a lot of fun and I don't know, being goofy, and he was just really quiet like all morning. And then we went and we walked up to like my favorite view of the city, which we had been to a couple days before. And he kind of like walked me over this little lookout. And then I honestly don't remember a word that he said. He says that I said yes. I'm not sure to this day. But yeah, it was really special. He put a lot of thought into it. But yeah, I somehow didn't see it coming at that time because it was at like 8:30 in the morning. Like, I figured he would do it at night. So the whole morning I was just being goofy and silly, and he was like trying to get focused. My promise to Braxton is that I'm always going to grow and change with you. I feel like we've gone through so many lifetimes together, just so many big changes, and we have so many big ones coming that I promise I'm always going to be committed to you and committed to pushing our relationship forward and growing with you. And I also promise to always tell you whenever you have green in your teeth, because somehow you always do.
All right, so what is my promise to Emily? You know, we spend a lot of time in our all of our relationship talking about the rest of our lives together, because it always has felt like we're trying to get to the next place, because we've been going through school, dental school, maybe have to move, whatever happened. All these life transitions we're always talking about down the road. But what's that going to look like for us? What are our lives going to be like? Those conversations are some of my favorite with us, talking about our future together, giving each other our best every single day, doing the little things for each other, no matter what, like all of our little traditions that we have together. We collect tickets from every single place we go as a couple, and we have a book that we put them in, to keep things like that alive, to have like our animals even just continue to, like, you made me a lover of like just having our little family before having our real family, and just continuing to do all of the things that make you so special to me and me so special to you. I always want to give you my best every day, no matter what's going on in our lives. I think my promise to you is to just give you my best self. I think I owe you that. You promising to spend the rest of your life with me, that's something big that shouldn't be taken lightly, obviously. And being able to support you in whatever aspirations, big dreams that you have, like whatever route that takes us on, like we're gonna make it. I will always be your biggest supporter, someone to lean on when times are tough, be there when times are incredible, celebrate you, to travel the world, to have our little family, our animals, our cow one day, Milton, whatever life throws at us, that's all of those conversations. I know you know what I'm talking about, when no one else is around, building our lives together, like, That's what I want, and I know that's what you want, and I promise to give you all of that and more and my best every single day to where we have our best lives together. So this is such an incredible time in our lives. Just this chapter, everything we're going to be going through in this next year and for the rest of our lives. And we couldn't have gotten here without any of you guys that are sitting here listening to this right now. And we're so thankful, so appreciative, for you guys just making the trip out here to be here with us today. Just being such a huge part of our lives. Whether you know it or not, each and every one of you, I can promise you, has made an impact on both of us. Not just if you're close with Emily, like her friends, her family on me, my friends, my family on her. Like We really couldn't thank you guys enough, and thank you for coming. Thank you for being such a huge part of our lives, and we're looking forward to continuing this, and you're stuck with us, so you're gonna keep coming. So thank you guys again. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.